Welcome, welcome, welcome. Day 77, making a Zelda-like game called Songbringer. Today, yesterday and the day before, actually, I've been making this boss called the Drop Boss. And he swings his hammer, hits the ground, makes a big old earthquake. So I'm kind of tired of actually working on this guy and making the art for him. It's been taking quite a while. So what I'm going to do today is, it's frequently in game projects, like, or any kind of long-term project, it's easy to get in these states where it's almost like you just don't want to do this. You feel like it's hard to do certain things. So to combat that, I'm going to go in the direction of what I'm excited about. And what I'd really like to do right now is to get this game so it's got a level one that's playable. So right now you can get into this boss room, but and you can beat him, but it doesn't drop the item. And you can get to the next room beyond it, the goal room, and but it doesn't have the item there either. So my goal for today is to make all of level one playable. And so what I'll be doing is hooking up the items and basically making it so at least this is a functional boss. Rather than right now, he's kind of like, you know, he's almost functional. So making this whole level one just playable and functional. That's today's goal. So the first thing is to get him so he drops an item when he dies. And I want him to drop the actual a life container, and then the top hat's gonna be in the next room beyond it. So let's draw the item for the life container first. So I'm going to go to the HUD. What's up, wizard? Yep. Items. The items I'm working on today are the life container, which is going to be a big orange. For now, I'm still kind of debating whether I want life / courage to be oranges. Heart would make the most sense because, you know, hearts are easily identified with courage, but I almost think that's kind of cliche, so I don't know. Oops. There we go. So I'm going to draw a big heart. Big orange. It's going to be like twice the size. That's good. Put my art pen in it. Yeah. Get this art pen out real quick. I can plug it right into my keyboard. Wow. Learn something new every day. This actually works. Okay. So we're drawing a big orange for the life container. Just kind of rounding it out, sprinkling in some texture to make it look like it's an orange. Okay, that those textures have, I mean, this an orange kind of has like that, those little pores. So I'm just dotting it with slightly different pixels. Give it that look. This might be a little too big. So, I need to see it in the game before I make any more moves to this. This is good enough to try. So I'm going to make this a layer base slice so that it's really easy to export all these frames. And this is going to be called live container. And I'm exporting this and I'm making sure to click all user slices from Photoshop so it doesn't give me a bunch of random slices I don't need. This is in HUD. Cool, so we've got that. Now I'm gonna hook it up so the boss drops that item when it's dead. In fact, I'm gonna give every health component an item so I can do this the right way. Right now, it randomly drops an item when an AI dies. That's not how it should work. It should work that I set up a health component with a preordained item that it will be dropped. What's up, Kid Virtue? Welcome to the stream again. So today I'm hooking it up so the game is playable all the way through level 1. So the goal today is I'll get it so we can go through the first level, fight this boss, get an item from him when he dies, so he'll drop an item, and then you go to the next goal room and the goal room has another item, and once you get that item, it closes the window and puts you back in the overworld. So that's the goal for today, a fully playable level 1. Okay, there. We've got a health item there. So each health component has an item, and that way it'll drop that item when the foe dies. So item equals K. Item none by default. And in the system where it drops an item, that's in change HP. Where did I just missed it? There it is. Leave an item. We're going to go world area create item. This is just making things how they should be. This will be really cool. What's up, Zajeko? No, it does not. I am not. And hello. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, this is CocoSootieX only. And, I made that decision because I don't want to ever actually release this on HTML5. A lot of it's because of the headache involved in making a cross-platform HTML5 and native game. It is such a headache to always go and make sure your code works on HTML5 as well. And so, I'm not even going to do browser-based gameplay. This is only for Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, and Android, and if the Kickstarter goes well, it'll also be for PlayStation Vita and like Wii U, maybe some of those other ones like that. Yes, it does. CocoSootieX CocoSootieJS actually contains CocoSootieX. And when you're using CocoSootieJS, you're actually using CocoSootieX underneath for your native platforms. And so I'm just using CocoSootieX. I do have the JavaScript library, so I'm quasi in between. There, I can use JavaScript in my game if I want, but I don't want to because CocoaStudioX is so fast, C++ is so fast, it's also very reliable, and JavaScript is a tiny bit unreliable in development. So I just want to make a solid native PC game and release it on Steam. Okay, so we've got the item in place to create that there. Now, when we're creating enemies, here we go. Good, so we can push back. An item. So if this is a boss, how do we tell if this is a boss? Or we just do the flags. Okay. Flags and K flags, flag boss. Actually, we'll do all this deciding the item outside of this loop right here. So item type item equals K item none by default. This is where we're going to go. If flags and flags boss item equals K item life container. So the boss is going to drop a life container. And all the other kind of enemies are going to choose randomly between different items. So this is all going to be if r is less than this, item equals that. So this first decides the probability that it will even drop an item. And then if it does decide that it's going to drop an item, it randomly chooses between a certain amount of items based on another probability factor. So twofold probability factor here. Okay, great. We've got this item all set up. We can put this up here too. Long Shorts, welcome to the stream. Hey, yeah. Actually, this is a totally different style of design than inheritance. And I just recently started going with this. It's called an entity component system. And entity component systems don't work that way in the sense that that you inherit. You compose. So, for example, when I'm creating an enemy, like right here, first thing I do is create an entity. The entity is simply just an integer ID. That's all it is. An entity is simply just an integer. That's all. And then you can add specific components. You probably know about this entity component system, but already. So if I'm explaining this and you already know, just stop me. But adding components is really, really cool way to compose an actual entity, because each component is specifically just data. And then systems are the only thing that actually operates on the data. So everything is compartmentalized. There's systems which operate just on the components and the entities. And there's never, ever any classes or inheritance design in this system at all. So it's a good suggestion, though, on how to find out if one of these is actually a boss. But for now, the way I'll do that is just checking if it has the level, the area, for example, that we're on, has the flag of K flag boss. But so entity component design has completely revolutionized the way I make games. I say that in a lot of my streams, but it is awesome, really. Because, I don't know, I've made games with inheritance design in the past. Almost every game I've ever made has been that way, because that's kind of what I thought. Oh, C++, object-oriented, got to inherit. But really, entity component design, component systems are the way to go. They make everything so much better in a lot of different ways. Okay, so now we're going to add it to the health component. So I'm going to get its health component for this ID and set its item to item. So the next thing we need to do is hook up the graphics for the for that. Yeah, there's actually a great article on it from Ray Wenderlich. If you just search for Wenderlich entity component system. Yeah, this is the very first result on Google. It's called Introduction to Component-Based Architecture in Games. And this is what I used. I read through this article and kind of digested it before I wrote my entity component system for this game, which is custom for this game. So, oh, cool. Welcome, Zeith. Okay, we've got that item hooked up. Now just going to hook it up the graphics for it. So this is in component.cpp. There's a function for gear. There's a map which maps item types to pings. So kItem, life container to life container. There. Now I think that's everything we need to do for the boss to drop some health when it's done. I want to give the boss less health too, because right now he's like, he takes forever to kill. Because he's got 48 hit points. I'm going to take that down to just 24. I do want him to be kind of difficult. And also I want to make the last room of the dungeon to have an item and so that is going to be, where do I set up? I don't set up, wait. So there's the key cards which are placed. How do I place those keys though? I forget. It's flag key, something like that. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, cool, man. I'm glad. I hope that inspires you. That's a it's a great article to check out. Just to, you know, just like once you kind of like read through it, maybe read through it again. Like it took me like two or three nights to really kind of understand and get the value of entity component systems. But once I finally understood, then I was like, oh, okay. And then I wrote this system and I'd never ever want to switch back. It's so, so great. Okay, great. We have this create items thing, which works with flags, but I don't think this is the best way to go about it. I think when I create an area, it should have a setup function which creates an item. Yeah, we're going to do that right now. So when we set up areas, it's going to have item types. And wait, a couple more things. Item type, item.
Turn the light here.
So great. Now it's going to have an item we can place. It's not going to have to use a flag and use up tons of bits depending on how many items we have in the game, which is that's going to be good. So here we're going to go when we set up an area. We're going to take an item type and store it. Oh, Zajago, it totally works well in Java. In fact, the one of the most popular entity component systems is written in Java. It's called Artemis. Artemis something. Artemis entity system. Here we go. Here you go. Check this out. It's gamadu.com/Artemis. It's written in Java. And it also goes into how entity component systems work and everything, but great article. Great system. What the heck? Come on. Don't give me ads. I hear you, man. Oh, yeah. Zeith, right? We're talking about the same thing again. Zeith. Always on the same level. I pulled it up. Check it out. Cool, man. Yeah. All right. So we've got this item there, and then when we go and create items, we can use it. Create items. So now we don't even need this, because we can just... Okay. See how we're doing on compiling right now? Make sure I didn't introduce any new compile errors or anything. Yeah. Delay. And then the last thing is going to be hooking it up in the world. Okay, I thought there was another item here that was... Okay, so I'm going to call this area item instead. Because item is too pretty common. Okay, so there's one slight problem with this because containers, like containers, are, long shorts, I do believe it is compatible with LiveGDX because I think Artemis is written sort of engine independent. I'm not sure though. So this is a problem here with this has because it's checking if, okay, I'm gonna make one more component function in gear. This is going to be called static bool is singular item. Or now is probably better because there's going to be mostly singular items. Whatever. I'll just return a not. Okay. So I'm going to make an isSingularItem function. Yes. Right. Exactly. Oh! Sorry, long shorts. Holy crap, did I actually call this isEquipable i10 this whole time? I can't believe I misspelled something. This is so wrong. Man, that's what happens when you're going fast. So it's going to be a singular item if it's not a plural item, I guess. Plural items are, okay, life container. Okay, item, life container, and some other stuff too. Yep. Yeah, there's not really a performance difference. It's more of just a design difference. Hmm. So there's going to be a couple other items that fit into this category. Bombs. But we're not really creating those often. I can leave that off for now. It's just gonna be life container for now. So that's is singular. And then in this area, now we can go has equals, well, if has, wait a minute. So this item container, this chest, we are gonna need to actually make it. We're gonna need to uniquely identify each different life container because I want it to, if the player ever does come back into this room, I want that the life container, this container for it to be open already. So I just wrote that function for nothing, but okay. You know what, for now, this is gonna be kind of boring to watch on the stream, so I'll do that later. I'll make it so each life container is its own item ID. So that'll make this system work. But for now, this will still work. We'll be able to play through this level, open up this container, this thing, and actually for now, I'll use that function. If gear component is singular item, area item, or a singular item. No. Has and not. Right? If you have the item already, like if has for a life container would be one. Has and not. And is. Oh man. Logic. Why is logic not making any sense to me right now? Gear component. It's because I'm doing all these knots. Area item is a K-Life container. It is not singular. Wow. My brain is at a new low today. Just gonna leave that off for now. Okay. Okay, all I wanna do now is add it to the area. So it actually is passing in from the world to the area, the keys, and the item. Cool. Glad that was a good good discovery today. Okay, so this is where it's going to pass in the key. So if it has a certain flag for a key, it's going to place it here. So here's where we're going to go with the flags and k flag goal. It's going to do the special item for now. I don't think I have a list of these yet for each area created, so I'm just going to do k item top hat. So that will place a top hat in every one of the dungeons, but we're only going to be concerned with the first dungeon at this point. So where's the z? I think it's just p.z. Yeah, p.z. There we go. Get item type for key, PIZ, flag key one. Yes. Okay, this is going to work to create an item. Either keys or the actual item in the goal room. There we go. Wait, did I do that right? No. Okay. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to delete all of my save games. Defaults delete com.wizardfoo. Oh, I'm also going to get the game to not skip the menu so we can actually create. No, wait, it'll automatically do that. Okay. Wizardfoo.songbringer. There. Bye bye, save games. Okay, I think that's everything. We got the boss now, so he's a little bit easier to fight. He at least needs a death animation, or simple death. So I'm going to do a one single frame death for him for now, where he's just laying on the ground. So he's just going to like immediately fall on the ground. It's not going to look that good at all, but it'll at least show that he's dead. So it's going to be called Draw Boss Death. And the cheesiest way to do this is just to rotate it. Bam! Put them on the ground. Here we'll squish his arm up to here. Lay this arm on his other. Okay. It's really horrible, but at least it will signify that this guy has passed from the land of the living. Right. Yep. You're watching me do programmer art today, but really, I really am just excited today to get this level one to be playable all the way through. That's all I want. I'm hooking up his death animation. Okay. What's the one remaining error we got here? Two for you arguments. Oh, yeah. We're doing this. We're going to do Catum None. This is for the overworld. There are no items yet in the overworld. Oh. Okay. So I think this is ready to try. We've got the boss in there. He's going to be in the room. He's going to supposedly drop a life container when we kill him. Once I go to the boss or the goal room after the boss, it should give me the final item there. There's not going to be any flux that will get me, that will close the screen and then put me back in the overworld yet. But I'll write that next. And so I don't know what level we're going to play here. Actually, we'll do a totally different world code, so it just is a surprise to play. So I hope this all works on the first try. I doubt it will, but we'll see. We'll do... Ichabod. Ichabod. Yeah, basically, I want to put some story in there too, though. So, narrative is going to be one of the next steps. So when you pick up the sword, it's going to play a little bit of the story, and I'll do a little bit of, maybe one tiny cutscene before you start it all. But yeah, it's going to be mostly polish and artwork and things like that. Cool. I love how the rocks are actually textured a cool color now. This is looking pretty good. So I don't have the sword yet. I can't fight these blobs. I gotta go in here and grab the sword. So level one, thankfully, the entrance is pre-programmed to be directly above the start. But of course, once the overworld procedural generator is better, it'll place that in a nice random place. So we're at Megaseed Ichabod. I have no idea where anything is, but let's start exploring. Oh, there's no incentives to actually fight these guys yet, right? I'm not getting any like benefit for fighting these guys in this room. So that needs to change. Okay, but I got lucky and actually went towards the right place for the key. This is actually really fun to not know where things are. There needs to be more rewards, though. For example, this is a dead-end room right here. It really needs something cool in it. Like at least some cash, some diamonds, a map, you know, like maybe your map or maybe the compass for this actual dungeon. I realize why these guys aren't as hard, or they're not as scary, because they're not as smart in the very first dungeon. So that's why they weren't working so good yesterday, and they're not as difficult to fight. It's because it's the first dungeon, so I still can't hit him. And, oh, he's smart enough to get me, but whoa! Well, they're a lot better when they're in a pair, that's for sure. They need to attack more, though. They need to like still try and hurt me. I'm almost dead. Oh, bug. So there's still some pulverizer enemies up here that are alive. And that's preventing this from opening up this lock. So dang, we gotta fix that. What's up, Tommy27? I don't know. Let's find out. Is it ALC? Is that the command? No, it's... What's the command for counting lines of code? Sweet, Massey. Glad you like the hooded guys. Yeah, so I gotta fix that bug, but what's the... I'm actually interested to know how many lines of code are in this game already, too. It's L something. I think. Clock. Yes, I do have plans to do that. All I gotta do is draw a few little blood splotches. Oh, WC. Duh. WC-L. And then there's something else I can do. Clock? Is it really clock? Oh. I don't have that. It's not on Mac. It's probably on Linux, though, or something. I think there's another bit of WC, though, that... Whoops. Can count the total. I know I've done this before. There it is. Oh, no worries. Thanks for the suggestion, and welcome, Justy. There we go. It's 24. Can't be 24,000 lines of code already. There might be. There's 2,000 lines just in system. Wow. I'm kind of impressed. There's already 24,000 lines of code. But some of this is OIS, which doesn't really count. That's a library I'm using for gamepads. Anyways. Okay, let's fix that bug. It's not unlocking the doors because the pulverizers are still alive. They shouldn't count in that. So the easiest way to do that, it would be to say, like, when I'm counting the enemies. Oh, right? I actually would be prouder if I had less lines of code than more, for sure. And before, when I was a younger programmer, I would have been more proud to have more lines of code. But now I'm much more proud to have less. It's like less to maintain, less headache. This thing where I'm counting foes. Foes should not count if their health is like super duper high, like they're just never gonna die. So if it's less than 900. Okay, let's try that again. It should put me right at the beginning of this level. And I should have both the key cards still. Oh no, I don't have the second key card. Oh, of course, I never got the second key card. Oh! These guys are pretty difficult, actually, even on their lowest intelligence setting. What? It's not working. Okay, I did something wrong. Okay, let's check out these guys, the pulverizers. They have 999 hit points. Oh, but that's multiplied by like a third or something. Now, there should be something that's called like invincible. Or how could I check that these guys should not be counted in the foe count. I mean, just for now, I guess I could just stay with this. So if the hit point is less than 300, foe count plus plus. That's not the right way to do this, but for now, it should work. All right, cool. It opened up this time. All right, we got the Cyan Killer key card. That should open the door to the boss's room. I don't know where that is, so we're gonna have to explore a little bit. Wait, this was that empty room. Okay. Probably right here at the beginning where I saw that other door. It's kind of weird to put these little blobs here in this room. Blobs are a great way to get some health back though, because there's so many in a room. Usually you get some health. There, I got a little health. I got some bombs already too, that's cool. So this is the kind of room where I should have locked the doors too, so there would be a reason to fight these guys before the boss. There's a lot of little things I need to do that like that to change the dungeon to be better, but... Okay, so this boss fight's not going to be awesome, he's not going to die all cool, but I'm going to see if I can actually beat him. I only have one heart, and now I have half a heart. Oh! I don't know, this is hard. There's no health in this room. Quit. I want to quit. Okay. Let's give it another go. Oh, continuing doesn't work yet. Okay, this time I'm going to try not to fight anybody. Oh, gosh. Okay, now I kind of need to fight these guys to get some health back. Oh, come on, yay! What? Oh, it didn't say that I got the key card? Lame. Guys were a lot easier to fight that time because they didn't put up a fight. So I gotta tweak that AI to make those guys a little better. Their behavior tree, just a couple changes here and there to make them so they pursue you a little bit more. Oh, I would like a little help, but it's not forthcoming. Thank you. Yeah! Okay, so there's a super cheesy death animation. It's cool, I got a life container out of that, though. Oh, no, I can't pick it up? Why not? Dang. Okay, for some reason, I cannot pick up this life item. I'll have to figure out what happened there. Let's see if we can at least get this item, though. All right. We have the top hat, and let's see if I can select it. Yay, cool. Awesome. Got the top hat. Okay, so the bug was that the life container was not able to be picked up, and also the top hat didn't show a description. Yay! So, item, top hat. Top hat.ping. What's up, Black Iron? So that should hook that up. So we've got the top hat. I'm pretty sure it's called top hat.ping. Raw sheets items. No, raw sheets HUD. Yeah, it's just top hat.ping. So that should work, hooking that up. So it's got some text when you pick it up, that item. Why wouldn't it allow me to pick up that health component, or that item component? I'm pretty sure that the AI system would have killed, no, the health system would have killed its collision component for the enemy. Yeah, it has a death animation. Okay, I'm gonna do this though. I'm gonna make sure that it's deleting a bunch of these components when it kills an enemy by moving it there. Instead of inside this animation bit. I'm not seeing the advantage. Oh, I used to have this here. Oh, this isn't even part of the system anymore. Okay, never mind. This used to be something. Don't need it anymore. So we don't need this. Don't need to even get the animation there. And then this can all be part of the same bit of code now. We'll use filter category foe. So the most important things there are to clear the behavior and then remove the components and then do some effects, leave an item, save the sprite. Okay, so we're good there. It's deleting the collision component. So it wasn't that it couldn't stand on top of it, or it was getting occluded by a different collision component. What could it else could have been? Oh, maybe the area actually doesn't even set up to be dropping items yet. Create item. Well, I know it created the item because I saw it. Oh, I know. There's something that picks up the item, of course. That's what it was. Ah, okay, there's a pickup item function, which just I didn't even hook up yet. So that's what was going on. What's up, Wisesso? Hello again to you two, and welcome to the stream. Confetti! Confetti! Apparently there is a way to do confetti, and I've been checking out Twitch alerts, so I'll eventually get some cool stuff on this stream. Here we go. Now we'll be able to pick up a life container. I imagine it'll be similar to... Oh, any one of these. What's up? What's up, Storm? Doing great, man. I'm hooking up everything in the game right now, so level 1 will be playable. Which means you can pick up the boss drops a life container, and then the next room has the item that you gain for that level, the goal room. And then once that's all going, I'm gonna make a little sequence where when you get the final goal, it does this thing where it like closes the curtains almost of the story, and then you appear back, elevating back down to the overworld. So yes, totally, you're right. It is almost the same kind of design. It's called the entity component system. And we were talking about that earlier. But yeah, it's a great way to make games based on entities rather than using classes. Yes, I know, right? I need to have a donation button. I was looking at that today. And I looked at Patreon. I looked at Twitch alerts, which looks really good. And also I looked at Stream Tip. So I'm still just kind of like weighing the different options and kind of deciding how I want to approach that, you know, how I want to do it in a unique way. Because really my whole goal here is to write an awesome game. That's all I want to do. I don't care if anything else happens out of this. I'm not doing this to try and make a living just by streaming. My whole goal is to make an awesome game. So I want to approach that in the right way. So yeah, there will be some kind of donation thing soon, which will be really awesome to have some help from people, from you guys, to just make a living and be able to actually keep on doing this full time. So thank you. Thanks for mentioning that. So we'll play a pickup sound. Increase the number of life container items you have. Clamp it. Delete the entity. There's no need to equip it. But we do need to go area set life. Oh, there's no set life containers yet, so I gotta write that function. So there's set life. There needs to be, oh, set number life containers, there it is. Why does it have to be called set num? Changing that. Set num. We're going to call this set live containers. So I don't do this again where I'm like, oh, I guess I should write that function. There we go. Oh, it's going great, man. The last 2 days I've been drawing this boss. This is the worst example right there. But yeah, this boss guy, he's huge compared to the player. And just like I animated his walk, animated his idle, animated a pretty cheesy melee attack for him for now. I mean, this is not looking that great, but I'll get it better. And also, I just did a single frame where he's just dead. This is super cheesy right now, where I'm kind of blowing through this as fast as I can so I can get level one to be totally playable. And that's going to be a good feeling, I think. And I kind of needed to take a break from doing all this art for this boss guy because, I don't know, it's good to switch gears and get into different zones and get excited about things. And the thing that I'm excited about the most is having this level be playable. So, life containers. This is going to be e.gear.has. Okay, item. Life container. Do believe set life containers. Now this might need to be plus. Yes, I'm streaming it right now. I just did it once, actually twice. Once I played through all of level one. And I'm going to do it again here in a second. I'm just making a few bug fixes to it. So I do need to add plus min life containers there. Nope, I'm going to change that. I'm going to make it so the function does that for me. So set life containers here is going to be n plus equals. Actually, n equals, no, we'll just do plus equals. I need to clamp it again. Okay, good. That should be able to set it up, so we're actually going to be able to pick up this life container now. Yeah, totally, right? Yeah. Hey, welcome to Astralgic. Yep, I wanted that feeling of it all working and all together now. Okay, so this should work. You'll be able to pick up that item now. And let's test it. Let's just see. And the next thing I'll do is I'll program it so it does it like an exit sequence. So the curtains close and it sets you back at the overworld. And then we'll be able to play through level one again one more time and see how it all flows. Oh, is that too loud? No, that's all right. I'm out of bombs. Oh, I have the top hat this time, so I'm kind of cheating. That's good, I'm cheating because he's hard. Alright, cool. Alright, it worked. Oh, but one more thing, I want it to give me full health too. And also it should have more flair. There should be more going on when you actually pick that item up. It should seem awesome. But that's going to be a whole hour or two project in itself, I'm sure. So I'm going to give him full health here. e.health.hp. No, max HP. Oh yeah, we need to redo max HP in this one. So I do that, max HP. No, it's gonna be create transients. Oh, it's in load game, actually. Well, where the heck is it? Max HP. There it is. K life container per container plus min life containers plus E has number of life containers. Yes. This needs to be a small function somewhere. might as well be a method of health component. Health system. Yeah, health system. Okay, so health system is going to get a static method, which is static void set max HP. For an int. Health system set max HP for E. Make this little method. And just check that it does have a health component and it does have a gear component. If is empty or that's empty, return there. Simple little method, sets the maximum hit points. So I can do that in two places now. This is health system. Set max HP for the entity E. Okay. So we're good there. I'm going to go and do this one more time to make sure it gives me full health. And yeah. So I'm going to want to delete a few things. One, I don't want to have the top hat anymore. And two, I shouldn't have the life container. So, which item number is that? It would be nice to actually hook this up and parse it. So these are actually parsed rather than being integers here in the actual defaults. It'd be nice if they weren't, if they're actual strings, so I'd know this offhand. Life containers. 0, 1, 2. So we have 0 of those and top hat 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Top hat is 7. There. Say, I'm going to test this one last time, and then we'll do a flux for closing out the level. Ooh, bombs. Oh, he got me. I almost had him though. There definitely needs to be some life in this room somehow. Just be able to recharge a little bit of your life. Maybe I'll put some the eponymous crate that you can bust open and have some health in it. Okay, going with no strategy didn't work either. It has surpassed me by much. So far, I'm finding that I can hide behind these little pillars. And that's a good way to fight this boss, or at least a cheap way to fight this boss. Oh, come on. Can you just give me a ride when I come in the room? Yeah, this is the super cheap way to win. At least I'm winning. Huh. Oh, it didn't refill my health. Alright, well. Oh, maybe I just forgot to set the health. Okay, I'm gonna go and get hit, actually, by one enemy first. And see if I actually do have full health. Wait, maybe... I don't know, I don't think I did. Okay, so I think I gotta set either the... Just set it visually, or something... Okay. What do you mean rasterized? You don't like the blur? No, the sprites are actually, it depends on what you mean by 16-bit textures. They're actually 32-bit color, but they're 8-bit style. There's a, Massey, there is actually a blur shader going on there, which is supposed to make them look like they blur as they go further out. But I could turn that off temporarily and we can see if it looks better that way. No, they're 32-bit color. There's really so little textures used that it's like... It's not that big of a deal. When you're doing pixel art, it's really great because you can fit so many textures or so many sprites into one thing. So like this has almost all of the sprites in the game are contained in this single sprite sheet, which is only 1024 by 1024. And you know, here on this Mac Retina I have, we could go up to I think 4096 by 4096. So I'm not sure I'm following you, but let me turn off the actual blur shader and I'll show you what I mean. I think I just call it blur. Yeah. Yeah, as long as I keep all the textures below 1024 by 1024. So here's what the game originally looked like. These are just like there's no blur on the shade on the shadows anymore. I like it better actually without the blur. I don't know. Kind of miss the blur actually in a way. Oh, they're not. They're not higher resolution. They're the exact same sprite that's used to make this the actual sprite you're looking at. It's just that it takes them and makes them black and then puts them at a skew angle. Yeah, right. Let's do a little check on this, actually. This is with the blur. Whoops. It's do... This room's all right. And it's hard to tell when there's so many different sprites. Or, I mean, so many different light sources creating so many shadows. This one's okay. Yeah, that's really hard to tell with actually with this bright blur going. Oh. So that's the skew. The skew is the only way I can do a shadow like that. I guess I could try and find out a way to skew it and pixelate it at the same time. I'd have to use a special shader for that. Yeah, so I think what it is open. Coco City X is using OpenGL, and I render everything to a tiny 420 by 240 frame. It looks about like this, actually. And then when I actually but then to see a really big screen like this, I add in one little scale factor in Coco City X, which is supposed to just scale the screen. And I thought it would scale the back buffer up so it would just be a bigger version of the 420 by 240. So this is it. I'm just setting it up where it's just 420 by 240 and there's only one pixel per pixel, basically. But then when it actually scales it up, OpenGL does something where it actually uses a higher resolution. So this is kind of what the game looks like. It's supposed to look like to the engine. Let's take a screenshot of this. So that's kind of what shadows would look like if it wasn't scaling it up the same. I wish I could figure out how to do that, because that would be the easiest way to solve this issue for good. Would just be to make it so it always just scales this up pixel for pixel rather than trying to scale it up and then... I don't know what magic, what voodoo actually Coco City X is doing for me to make these smoother. Yeah, I'm not sure how I can get this to actually work right now in the game, but I'll think about it. There's got to be a way to disable Coco City X from scaling everything perfectly for me. And it's not a resolution policy, because that just changes the window's size. I'll give that some thought. But yeah, I would like to actually get to this point where all it does is just scale up the game. Because I think that'll be a more efficient for how it renders my shaders anyway. So, okay, that's a goal for later. Okay. I'll put it on it. See, the thing, I don't know, sometimes I don't like writing ideas down because I forget to do them once I write them down. I'm like, oh, it's there in that ideas thing. And I never get to these ideas. So it's like sometimes the important things I like to just keep in my head. And that way I remember to do them. Maybe that's a character flaw of myself. I don't know. Scale up. Get Coco City X to not scale up the back buffer. Okay. Write that down. Yeah, and I'm also curious as to how it works on iOS. Well, it totally would. This would mean that I wouldn't even have to make a higher res, or I wouldn't have to make a low res circle effect, because I would just use this one and it would perfectly render it as pixels for me. So, okay. That will be really cool, actually, to get that done. I think the game will run a lot faster, too. And look better. Look true to the pixel. So there's one thing here. One bug was that... Oh, duh. This is the problem. It didn't set its HP right here. So this is going to be times min life containers plus, oh, duh. This is all just like this. Oh, no. This is like this. Okay. Yeah, it probably does, huh? Nice. Right on. Huh. Cool. That's probably a good trick to know in Unity. Max HP. And then this is going to be like that. And then the other system... This is where we set e dot health dot hp equals this times e dot health dot max hp. And then not only we set the life containers, but we set area set life to be e dot health dot hp. So that should work. Huh, wow. Okay, so while you guys are chatting about that, I'm gonna go test this one more time and make sure that we can pick up this life container. Actually, I need to set my items to zero again. Cheat. I feel like I'm cheating. Alright, we got full health. Yay. If I get hit, I just... Nope, I don't. I just got hit and I still have... Apparently have full health. I must have done something wrong there. Should have set a breakpoint. I know that's all right. Okay. Okay, so So we've already increased the life container's amount. This entity's gear component should have one more, number two. I'm not sure, second is zero. Oh, it hasn't done this yet, okay. Boom, good, it's on set to one. After we clamp, still one, that's right. Let's see what's wrong with max HP here. Eta health on max HP equals K life per container times min plus however many you have. So after I do that, what's my health before? Actually, health, max HP is 6. Afterwards, it should be 8. Good, that's 8. Now, this one, K life per container times max HP. Oh, that's the problem. Okay, that's an obvious bug right there. This should be Eta health on HP equals Eta health on max HP. So I'm going to take a look and verify that is what the problem is. So max HP is 8. If I do this, it's going to be 16, which is obviously twice the player's max health. So just remove this. That was the bug. Set this to 0 once more. Test it one more time. And then we'll do a flux to close the curtains. Okay, very good. Just verified that I now have the correct amount of hit points after receiving that health item. And now I can just go and make sure that when I pick up this goal item here, it does the flux out. So we're going to need another we've already initiated a phase where you pick up the item. So it's not like we need a phase of its own for this. It just needs a different or it doesn't need a new flux type, it needs a new phase, that's all. So in my fluxer things, just transitions, I'm going to have K phase close. Very similar to K phase open. Now if in phase item, at the end of it, if the area world area dot get flags and k flag goal transition phase k phase close else none. Now the transition phase close is going to go from close to elevator down. Cool, man. Nice. It's good to make progress like that in Unity, right? So, similar to phase open. Phase open. Oh, not flux close. Yeah, there's nothing so far that does that. Okay. Phase open. Oh, so is that a good thing? Is Unity 5 better than Unity 4? Okay, I want that. That's fine. Might need to do this, I'm not sure. Ah, cool. We don't need to do any of those. We're just setting it up so it... Oh, I see. This delays it for a moment there. I could tell. I don't think Massey would ever miss a perfect like a pixel being off for sure. So let's just make auto A 1.0 minus alpha. I don't think this is necessary either. Cool. So next thing this phase is going to do is go to cave phase elevator down, and we need to set the area too. I'm not sure how I'm going to find that, but for now I'm going to go new area pause. Just set this to manually to something. This is like a hack right here, but I'm just hacking in the place where I know the elevator is. It's just to see if this elevator action works. And so that will go to phase elevator down. Phase elevator down, let's see if this actually works with its Yeah, that should work actually. This might actually work. Okay, make sure I don't have the items. That was close. Oh, didn't do the item. Come on. Okay, I'm gonna figure out why I didn't do that. Yeah, I heard that. Wow. Free profiler. Free profiler. Get your free profiler. There's a K-flux item. Why didn't it call that? Here's where it calls it. Oh. Here we go. So when you pick up the top hat, launch that flux. K-flux. Oh, it's just a K-flux item. Come on, flux close for me. Oh, I forgot to hook up that string. Ooh! Oh, it almost works. At least it did the close. And now I'm stuck in some zone that I have no clue. Okay, I'll fix those two things in a sec here. We'll be right back. I'm going to take a little, get some water. Two issues. One was it didn't do the right string. I guess it's gonna be a flux item, phase item. Oh no, it's just in gear component. It's not here. What? Get localized string for text key. Oh, right, there's a text key. Duh. Okay, so that's in system. Same as this. Set text key. There it is. This is just item top hat. That's all. That's all I needed to put that string in there. I think it's just item top hat. Yeah, item top hat. Cool. That will do that. And then the next thing was it just got stuck after that and it didn't do anything. Let's see. Let's go back through. Phase gear. Okay, we went from phase close. Phase close. Oops. It successfully did this. That was cool. Really glad it did all this. But then it did. Goes transition phase equals K phase elevator down. That should. K phase elevator down. That should just set the phase the correct way. I don't think there's anything else that goes on there. Phases? No, phases already works. What could possibly be going on here? Okay, I'm just gonna step through things. I gotta step. Phase item. No, phase close. That works. Phase close. Oh, not phase elevator down. Should be phase fade out, fade in. Fade in. And then that triggers. Actually, I should go flux type. K flux elevator down. And then do fade in. That's how it should work. Okay, so fade in is going to go and create the new, set the new area pause. Create the new area. Delete the old area's entities. Okay, let's see if that works. Oh my god, I've totally have wanted to so much. I love Metroid. Love Metroid so much. It's probably one of my favorite games besides Zelda. Zelda and Metroid, my two tops. I heard of one though called, I think it's called Ghosts On. Is that right? It's procedurally generated. That's not it. Is it called Ghosts On? No. But yeah, that's definitely what I want to do at some point. After I do this whole procedurally generated Zelda series, his Songbringer game. I think doing a Metroid-style procedurally generated world would be really fun to do, too. Definitely more on the serious side of making games, though. I don't want to make sort of like a cheesy platformer, but a serious platformer, those are cool. I love those. So I think that'll work. I don't care if I have a breakpoint. I'm going to try it. Ooh, I got so much health now. Keep on getting the same item over. Oh, I forgot to delete the item. Ghost Song? Is it called? I don't think it's called Ghost Song. Yeah, I don't know. I wrote it down somewhere. It looks super sweet. Maybe it was Ghost Song. Okay, I need to make sure that I make that text a little less long or put it on two lines. Let's see if this transition works. Come on, work. Oh, cool, it flickered, but that's all right. At least it's going back to the right place. And can I play? Yes, okay. Good, the transition worked. It just flickered because... Why did it flicker? Did it show the first area or the second area? What's up, campaign? It's going really good. Is this it? Yeah, that's gotta be it. That looks like it. It is called Ghost Song then. Yeah, this is it. This game looks sick. Super Metroid style though, in its play, it looks like. Oh wow, they're doing a pre-order for their game. That's a good way to do it. Cool. Yeah, I gotta check this out some more because this looks so awesome. Oh wow, they already did a Kickstarter as well? Oh, this is back in the day. September 2013. Wow, is this, I can't believe this game's not out yet already. Yeah, campaign, things are going great today. Finishing up a little bit of code here, which makes it so we can play through all the way through level 1. There's one remaining issue, and that's that flickered the area. Cave phase close. Yeah, phase close showed It's set these to false. So I'm going to do... fade in is going to set them to false. Sweet. Oh, wow, man. So, does that mean you kind of struggle with the confidence to do art, or like I did, or do you have like some other issue about art? That's cool you went to art school, man. I always thought it'd be so cool to go to art school. It sounds really fun. Wait, I gotta delete these items. So, clear that. Clear that. Okay, we'll try this one more time. It shouldn't flicker now this time. Gotcha. I'm getting better at fighting this guy. Or getting better at exploiting his weaknesses, I guess. Isn't that the essence of all boss fights, though? Yay! Didn't flicker. Alright, that's it. We got the transition working. Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, man. Wow. Well, you should be able to get it back fast then, I'm sure. If you already got a history with some art, I'm sure it'll be super easy for you to just pick up the pen again. Bam! Create some rad art. Distragic, what are you, what are you really excited about? That's what I always do when to get excited about things, I think, is a real important thing when you're creating games, so, or any kind of project, really. So what kind of game or project excites you the most? So I'm deleting everything again. We're going to start it again. Nice, man. Nice. You probably know exactly what to do. I'm sure you can do it. Okay, so I'm gonna play through a totally random area now this time. Try a totally new key world mega seed thing. So it'll generate a different dungeon. And we can just see if it all kind of flows correctly now. Let's call it Bitten in honor of Bitten Studios, who made Lena's Inception. This is in honor of you, Tom. Bitten. Or Biten? I don't know how you would say that. Is anybody from the UK here? Cool, man, yeah. What excites you the most? It'll make things easy, man. When you do things that are exciting, there's nothing stopping you. Okay, we got a weird color for sure for these rocks this time. But, I don't know, I guess it could... It's the patches of grass there that are kind of weird looking on the ground. All right, so this is basically going to be the end of the stream tonight. I'm going to fight through this level, and that's going to be it for tonight, basically. So this one's got a locked door right here. Let's see what we can find. Oh, I still need to hook up just more rewards for these levels. So as you go through the dungeon, you should find some cool stuff and more reasons, basically, to fight all the enemies. So I'm going to lock more doors and make them contingent on you defeating the enemies. That'll be one way to do it. Another way will be to give them more rewards, like adding a map, a compass. I want to do some other kind of item container besides these things, too. So you'll be able to hit something else or have some sort of thing that can contain items that's really cool, besides just this pillar in the middle of the room. So that opened up the red doors. I don't know where I'm going here. Oh, there's the blue door. All right, we found the blue door. That should go to the enemy or the boss. But I wouldn't know that if I was a player. Oh, found the blue key. Sweet. So I gotta defeat these guys. I gotta make these guys smarter for sure. Not bad. You got me that time. I'm low on health. Don't chase me. Oh, yes, no way. There needs to be more life in this game, that's for sure. So far, it is really easy to lose out all of your health. I'm at no health. Okay, there, I'll get a little health now. There's just nothing really that gets you that much more health besides killing some enemies, I guess. Oh, there. Just talking about having no health and I just got full health. Man, that's cool. I love seeing the doors in the top. Okay, I have no bombs. But I do have this exploit where I can sit here by this pillar. So I definitely need to take away these pillars. Because it's just too easy to beat the boss. Something like that, or make the boss smarter so he knows how to go around pillars. That's a pretty duh thing. Okay, so I got the life. This is the last key, or the last item. Got the top hat. It fades out. Puts me back to the world. That's all I wanted to accomplish today. Just getting it so we can play through level 1. So there's a lot left to do to make the level look more cool, that's for sure. What happens when you die? It's just like Zelda, you can either continue or quit. Yeah, definitely weird. It was. Zelda 1 was super brutal. Yeah, but I think I want it to be a little friendlier than Zelda 1. Maybe. Maybe permadeath mode is still just as brutal. But regular mode is less brutal. And there'll be an online leaderboard. So every time you run through the game, you'll get a score. And you'll be put on a leaderboard. And your scores are higher for permadeath mode. So thank you. Yeah, thanks everybody for watching. And thanks once again for comments, suggestions. I really, really appreciate everybody always sharing your thoughts. It's very cool. So that's it for today's stream. Thank you all.